It's going on, man. It's your boy Dan B. Hoodz. The news, who we got right here, man?
Jesse James, man.
Man, Jesse James, what's going on, man? You got me out here flying out this motherfucker,
man,
bro.
Out
West Bubble, man. This man got me out something county.
Man.
Like, but you run the DMV? But you gotta be coming. What you gotta be coming out here for like this?
Man, we gotta talk. So I had your ass come out here talk to a real nigga.
Man,
bro.
That shit crazy, bro.
Man. To like 4 or 5 days, man. But you hit?
It's what? Yeah, man. He kept hitting me up like, bro. I was like, bro. I told him one day, bro. I had to go do another interview and shit, man. I'm like, bro, I'm too tired, bro. I can't make it, bro. He's like, bro, come on, man.
You gotta do it.
You gotta do it, man.
They gotta hear this shit.
Yeah, man. Facts, man. Facts. So, man, all right, we're going to go through the background and shit like that, man. All right, so where you from?
I'm from Largo.
Largo.
Largo, man.
Largo, man. Some stars came out of Largo, man.
Yeah.
Whole time, though, man. Whole
this
time.
The next one right here.
You said this the next one right here.
My mother.
Yeah.
Talking to
facts, man. Like, I fuck with the confidence, man. Right. Having it. So, whole time, man. Tell me your background, because, you know, when people think Largo, man, they either think about Largo Road, you know, or they thinking like, oh, Big Homes, PG Community College. So, what was your life like growing up in Largo, man?
Shit. I came up in Largo. So I moved there when I was like 6. And I was like 4 or 5. Motherfucking came with my folks. Shit, we had a motherfucking. My house was designed like that. My house was the move. Like, niggas would leave school, early type shit, smoking my junk. Like, had the bitches come through, had the sauna on my junk, had the. But that shit was a move, I swear to God. My shit was a move, but. The shit, motherfucking. My shit, same regular shit, smoking, motherfucking. Got the window, I went to Wise. That shit was all right. Motherfuckers used to knee skirt, smoke, fuck. Just play basketball after school, shit like that. Motherfucker. Then niggas got in the shit. They got kicked out of school. Got kicked out of Wise.
Got kicked out of Wise, dang.
Yeah.
But don't y'all got your own high school out there? Y'all got Largo High, right?
Largo, yeah, but my motherfucking boundaries, like, the next neighborhood for mine was Largo, and my boundary was Wise. Like, the next neighborhood over to mine went to Largo.
Right.
My shit went to was Wise boundary.
Right.
I was sick at first, because everybody I knew I motherfucking went to Largo. I'm like, damn, don't put me a motherfucking
yeah,
Wise.
Facts.
What the fuck?
Yeah, facts.
But then the fuck with his Wise had the bitches. My mother.
Yeah.
My mother.
Yeah.
I was fucking with this.
Yeah, so he was happy with the Wise, but then
yeah,
you got...
That shit was cool.
But like, all right, so the thing is, though, is like you growing up in Largo is like, you know, middle class, the upper middle class. You got pockets of Section 8 out there, though. It's like the people be making it think like it's all everybody
all
rich.
Big houses, all the houses in Largo not big. They got apartments just like anywhere else. Like the shit we got now, they got shit like this in Largo. They got treetop.
Yeah.
They got hella shit,
bro. Yeah, I remember going around Prince Place back in the day. Yeah, yeah.
Shit like
fact.
That, like...
Yeah.
Niggas know Prince Place and Treetop. It's like, you only got to y'all know.
Yeah,
Treetop and Prince Place.
Yeah,
know.
Yeah, facts, man. Yeah, facts. So it was like some parts, you know, it was one sweet. And then y'all, like, it might be a little bit nicer, but
bruh,
y'all right next to one of the most, like, y'all next to some wild hoods.
It don't matter where you from, bro. It's bitch ass niggas and hoods. And
yeah.
Real niggas and big houses, bro.
Mm-hmm.
Where you from don't matter, bro. Like,
yeah.
Even if niggas had big ass houses and shit, that would mean shit, bro. I'm a real nigga, bro. Like, anybody can be a real nigga, bro. Like, you can be in from the hood and be a bitch.
Yeah, fact.
And you can be from big ass houses and be a real nigga.
Mm-hmm.
It matter who you is. It don't matter
Dave. Where
you from, bro.
Mm-hmm.
Fuck.
Mm-hmm.
I know niggas in the hood getting robbed.
Yeah, fact.
We ain't gonna speak on niggas, but.
Yeah, fact.
You dumb niggas.
Fact.
They shit took.
Man, nah, you ain't in line, though. Nah, that's really
my
facts,
brother,
though.
Bro.
That's really facts.
No matter where you from.
Yeah, facts, man. But would you say you had a hard upbringing, or you were just like, or you were just hard headed and shit?
Shit, it was both. Like, I ain't gonna say hard headed. Like, I had, like, my folks made sure I had what I needed type shit. Like,
right.
I ain't, we niggas wasn't going hungry and shit. You know
yeah,
what I'm
facts.
Saying? But I ain't had the best shit until I got to high school, and that's how I get my own money type shit.
Yeah, facts.
Wasn't until I get my own shit that was up, like, had all the shoes and shit. Like, yeah, I was looking sweet, like, my mother. Once
yeah.
Niggas are looking sweet, that's why I started doing anything. When I got to high school, that's why I started really fucking doing anything, like, for real.
Mm-hmm.
So shit, nigga was just shit, smoking, shit, doing all that shit.
Yeah.
When I started smoking, that's why I really started turning up. That's
yeah,
like,
fact.
That's why I started getting, I started taking my, I used to steal cars and shit, like, I used to take my mother's car, I used to motherfucking just drive and shit. man. I remember when I got kicked, man. I got kicked out of Wise. That shit was funny as
Yeah, tell me how you got kicked out of Wise.
Bro, I was about to fuck this bitch, bro. I swear to God, bro. Like, this bitch was with me. Was about to go fuck in my man car. I just went to my man, got his keys. After I got his keys, I see security guard look like walking some really fast as shit. I'm like, fuck, I already knew. Like, I ain't know what the fuck they wanted, but I knew it was coming for me. So I was bust. I get a bitch with the keys. I said, I just hold this down right quick. She's like, all right, bro. They pull me in the office. Tell me, they like, yeah, we see you. Cause I got kicked off with leave. I used to just leave early, bro. Like, this, the half a day, I used to fuck with the seniors and shit. So the half a day niggas, I used to leave with them niggas left. And I used to come back sometime, but most times I used to just motherfucking leave. You niggas just smoke, yeah, go facts. Home and shit, do some other shit. Mm-hmm. Some motherfucking. After that, I got kicked down with the Green Valley. Shit, that shit was cool. Niggas was telling me for like, yeah, it's a whole bunch of real niggas in that joint.
Green Valley, what's that?
Green Valley's alternative school.
Oh, PG County or something? Yeah. Oh, okay. It's alternative school. I know about choice. That's why I was like, oh yeah, I don't.
Nah, that shit in Suitland. It's like for joints for like, that's like for real niggas in that joint.
Yeah.
Niggas love about Green Valley. Yeah. That's where I met motherfucking. That's where I met Will at. That's when I first was supposed to make up a Where the Rapper do a song or
something. Yeah, fact.
He from Suitland. He went to Suitland. Some shit like that. He from Suitland. Some shit like that.
Yeah.
So I'm saying, I seen him, bro, one day. And then I heard him rapping, so I DM him on Twitter, trying to link up and shit. He was fucking with me and all that shit. And then I think he went to Wise too. I seen him somewhere else. Mm-hmm. Shit. After that, I was fucking with him. We ain't do a song till like two years ago though.
Yeah, facts.
Cause shit, he blew the pull up hop out jump.
Yeah, facts.
Yeah, that's alright. Mm-hmm. He was on that.
Wait, shit. Well, so did you end up graduating or you just?
Nah, not from Wise. Once I got kicked out, I came back to Wise the next year. But it was like, I got to take like 50,000 classes. I got to go to night school, summer school. I said, bro, I ain't about to do all that shit, bro.
Yeah,
so like, I said, fuck it. And then I went out North Carolina, stayed with my grandmother, jumped. Finished school off that jump.
Yeah.
Then I came back once I finished that,
yeah.
Got that shit out the way.
Yeah, dang, that's crazy. You had a hell of a story, bro.
That shit was fun to me, bro. Moving and shit. Mm. I done moved like 7 times, bro. I moved back up from North Carolina. I came back, stayed with my mother out Largo. And then we moved to these apartments out Largo. And then after that, I got my own crib out Cap Heights. Then after that, I went to move my folks out Waldorf. And then after that, we got to just moving around.
That's crazy. You was just traveling like a motherfucker. Really? And that's crazy, man.
I'm here with it.
So, it was any moment in your life when you jumped in, like, street activity, or you was just over the type,
stay out the way? Yeah, niggas on that shit in high school, you know what I'm saying? They was gotta say too much, but shit.
Yeah, facts.
Niggas on that shit.
You know what I'm saying?
But so it's mainly, like, money and shit.
So you was never into the
beef and shit? Nah.
Nah, not beef, but like, you know, be cool or, you know what I'm saying? Like, it was basically, like you said, it was to get money.
Yeah, like, only time some street shit happened, it's for money. Like, niggas are setting niggas up for money and shit, and niggas are upset. And that's the whole niggas are setting me up, you know, all that type of shit.
Yeah, facts.
But at the end of the day, that shit was, you know what I'm saying?
So yeah, what actually inspired you to start rapping, man?
Shit, and the kill is, once I got kicked out of Wise, I stayed with my man. I got kicked out. Nah, whole time, I went to Green Valley. I went to Job Corp after that. After I got
my, which one you went to?
The joint out Baltimore.
Oh, the Woodstock. Yeah.
I went to Job Corp, right? And you know you come smoking that joint. So motherfucking, I was on a basketball team and all that shit. So We went home for vacation. I mean, for Christmas break. I hit 1J. I came back to that jump. Piss test me. It got me the fuck about it. Like,
off of 1J?
Yeah, I was high. That shit was in my system. I failed the piss test.
So you must have, when you first got there, you failed the piss test.
Yeah,
when they gave you the piss test again.
Yeah.
I didn't even know they can piss you a second time. Yeah. I thought they had to have a reason.
They piss you when you come back from breaks and shit.
Oh, shit.
So, after that, I ain't even tell my folks I got put out that job. I just stayed with my man. He had a stew in his house for like for two weeks straight. Mm. I stayed in job. I was recording. Like, I used to make music. The niggas, you know, niggas were motherfucking freestyle in the car and shit, high as shit. And niggas, I used to spank niggas on the freestyles and shit. Mm. So motherfucker, I was like, fuck it. And then once I did that shit, I dropped the tape and niggas was fucking with it.
Right.
And then after that, when I first started though, I like my mindset was I'd rather pay for features and all that shit, and niggas are fucking me off of that. Like my first song was with Bankroll Maki. Like
when I remember Bankroll.
Thax first was jumping and shit. So shit, that's when Flock was locked though. That's what I was trying to defeat with, but he was locked. So I did the song with Maki, Boogie Snow, Freak Show.
Right.
All them Thax niggas.
So, man, we're going to talk about, man, this new tape that's coming out, man, or the, you know what I'm saying, these big names you got in your shit, man. I see you locking lit, man. You busy and shit like that, man. So, man, tell me who you got, man, I see you got this thing with Flock and shit, man. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? How did that come about?
Flock, motherfucking shit. I was locked in with his man. I got a song with Bankroll Maki.
Yeah, shout out Bankroll
Maki. Shout out Boogie. Yeah. I got Boogie Snow. Shout out Boog. Freak Show. Shout out Freak Show. I got songs with them. Mm-hmm. So shit, we just locked in. One day he pulled up. He pulled up to the stoop. He was dead. And just locked in.
Mm-hmm.
And then next day he went to the stoop again. Knocked out another jump. Shot the video. Go get that jump on YouTube. Jesse and Flock, Blicking for Life.
Go ahead and check that out right there.
That motherfucker.
Yeah, facts.
So shit, we got Flock. I got Flock on it. I got No Savage.
Oh, got No Drunk with No Savage?
No Savage.
Shit, man. How was it linking up with No Savage?
Shit, that shit all right. That's cool. My man.
Yeah, he cool dude?
He a real nigga. Shit, was in that joint locked in.
Mm-hmm.
We did a couple jumps, so shit.
Yeah.
He a real nigga.
You got a video coming soon? You see the video coming soon?
Yeah, we about to do a motherfucking video too. I got all that shit.
Yeah,
he a real nigga. I fuck with him.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, facts, man. Yeah. Shit, oh, you locked in. You got some big ties, man.
Zan, man. I was locked in with bruh like 2 years ago. When I first heard about him, I hit him up.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Niggas give, you know, that shit be, but we knocked that motherfucker out.
Right.
I got a song with Q.
Okay.
Q the Fool.
Okay, Largo, you know what I'm saying? Largo Unity. Shit. Yeah, Largo shit. Yeah, facts.
Shout out Q. He got a song with Will the Rapper.
Okay, that's probably some beats right there.
Will, I first saw fucking with bro back in the day. So we been supposed to lock in, got that shit out. So I feel like niggas got fuck with it. Like, who you going, like, that's like all bangers. Like, you can't fuck it. Like, niggas not fucking with that. Niggas ain't fucking with it, bro. Like, them all niggas' favorite rappers. Like,
yeah, facts.
I don't even do songs with niggas I don't fuck with. Like,
yeah, facts.
If I don't think you crank, I ain't gonna do a song with you just cause you got clout or some shit. Like,
yeah,
facts. If you don't crank, you don't crank. I ain't fucking with that.
So whole time, what you think you need to get you on that next level though?
More videos. I'm about to push out hella videos. You gotta see me. Shit, cause they gotta hear it. After this tape, niggas gonna hear me for real, bro.
Yeah,
like,
facts.
I'm talking that shit like it ain't. It's a whole lot of vibes on this motherfucker. Like, if you want that hard shit, that crank, I got that. You want that chill shit, I got that. If you going through some shit, bitch, I got that shit too. Like, I got all the motherfucking shit in this motherfucking vibes. You feel me? Facts. Like, shit, niggas a motherfucking
facts.
Feel me?
Yeah, facts.
Man, you take a shot of Duce, listen to that bitch, boy, your ass gonna be jamming.
Yeah, I've been listening to a couple tracks, man. Mostly awesome. You got turn up shit too. You got.
Bruh, fuck the turn up shit. The chill shit is what's gonna hit him.
Yeah, facts.
The bitch is gonna love this shit. It's like, man.
Yeah, facts, man.
I'm telling
you, bro. Who was actually like an artist that was your motivation to start rapping though? Or was it just fucking, I'm about to start rapping?
Shit. The nigga I saw, shit, I listened to Chief Keef in high school, so shit, he probably the nigga I listened to most when I first started rapping. Chief Keef. I listened to Lil Wayne a lot.
But yeah, facts.
Probably
Chief Keef. Yeah. So dealing with a lot of DMV rappers, you know, they got their dramas and their issues and shit like that too. What would you say like is the most difficult part of being a rapper in the DMV and dealing with artists, you know what I'm saying, from this region?
Dealing with rappers from out here in this region?
Yeah.
Shit. Niggas that act Hollywood. Niggas that act like too good to fuck with niggas, like, ain't nobody on yet, like.
Yeah,
even if you is, like, niggas that act like niggas get some clout and be like, And even like, even if you knew a nigga from before, niggas are acting like they too good to fuck with you. Like, we all from the same place, bro. But that's how it be. That's why I don't. You can't control how niggas act. That's why you can only motherfucking put the work in to get to that level. To motherfuckers. To where you only, you know what I'm saying? It'd be like, all right, whatever, bro. But yeah, regardless, I fuck with everybody though.
Yeah.
Like, Niggas, you ask niggas like, I don't even give about all that other shit, like.
Yeah, right. What's the next tape that's coming out though? I ain't even asked you that.
It's called Till Death Do Us Part 2.
Ooh. Oh, so it's a part 2.
Yeah. Okay. I got the part 1. I'm about to show you the cover.
Yeah. It's a part 1 or part 2?
This is a part 2.
Oh, yeah. Show me
I'm that. I'm trying to fucking camera though, man. Mm-hmm. The chocolate's cover. That shit looks sweet. They got a motherfucking redhead laying down looking sweet.
Yeah,
man, nigga, man, get the fuck out of here. Nigga should be boring as hell. I got this motherfucking cover was like $160 just to make the cover.
Facts.
Nigga be on that broke ass computer ass. Man, fuck out of here. But that shit, my motherfucking favorite song on that joint to me, probably with. I don't know. It's a lot, bro. You got
to hit it. I
got
this on myself. You want to give me a preview I can listen to?
Yeah, I got you for sure.
Yeah, facts, man. What's the, because you talk about artists being Hollywood. Do you ever think, like, or fail yourself, like, ever, like, feeling like, oh, I'm going to feel like I'm better than somebody when I blow up, or if I blow up or something like that? If not, then what would you do for the people that's coming up? Because I know you know what I'm saying? Cause keep it honest, you can't help everybody.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But you can do the best you do. So what's probably the first thing you do?
Shit. Put niggas on. The most I can do with niggas is put them on with songs and shit. Like, I can't. You can lead a day to water. You can't make them drink. So like, I can only put you in a position, and what you do after that is on you. Like, well, if you can't blow up off a song, bro, yeah, that's gonna bring you attention, clout, and all that shit. Like, that's the most with niggas. That's what be so hard for niggas. Cause niggas be like asking. Niggas be acting like you asked for a social security card number. I'm like, bro, it's just a song, right? Like, how long a song take, bro? Like 5-10 minutes, bro?
Yeah.
Like, come on, bro.
Yeah. You get in out that studio in like, what, 2-3 minutes,
bro? Every song on the dead, bro. Song with me and Flop, we did that shit probably like 5 minutes, bro. On God, bro. Both jumps.
Right.
The second song we got, the song we saw the video to, I already had recorded that jump. We just went in the studio, linked up, and he did his verse type shit.
Right.
But the jump, we got this, and we got another song, and I got shit out like 5 minutes.
Damn.
Like.
See, I just went straight off the dome and just said, fuck, yeah, we about to do that motherfucker.
No hook, found a beat, fuck with it. Hit that motherfucker.
Yeah.
Matter of fact, what that's gonna, I'm gonna play like 5 seconds of that jump.
Yeah, give him a quick preview, bro.
Man, shout out Flock. That's my nigga, bro.
Give him a quick preview, man. That already sounds like what they're crying.
I keep a great look flipping west. I got a fuck out of Kettle. I got a bit too much of Fettle. I woke up feeling like I'm Tony, the nigga. We only fucking on special occasion.
Yeah, oh shit, you got that shit on the way though. I ain't gonna lie.
That ain't even on the tape. That's why we just gonna keep locked in the vault.
Facts.
Saying
man.
Fuck it whenever.
Damn, you really got that shit.
I pulled up with Jesse.
Yeah, you got that shit on the way.
With the Western.
Yeah, you got that shit on the way though. I ain't even gonna lie. Yeah, but we need that video for that. Where you get your name from though, Jesse James?
Shit, my real name James. So shit, when I first started rapping, I was talking to my man. I was like, shit, bro, I need a motherfucking name, bro. He was like, shit, your name James? So fuck, just put Jesse in that motherfucker. I was like, all right, fuck it. I ain't know what the fuck that was. I had to motherfucking Google that nigga. That nigga had like a white motherfucking train killer, some shit. I don't know. That nigga, I said, all right, fuck it. We gonna rock out.
Yeah.
So I'm finna change that bitch, though, because it's too many motherfucking Jesse James.
I was thinking about Road Dogg, the Road Dogg Jesse. Remember WWE, WWF? Oh, yeah, Road Dogg, Jesse James and shit. That's what I was thinking about. Shit. I was like, damn, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
Right, but yeah. I'm finna change that bitch, bro. Like,
you or it could be like something Jesse James, like okay Jesse, yeah, like how your Instagram is or something.
Shit,
yeah.
It's hella motherfucking Jesse James. I'm like, God.
Yeah, because it's hard for me to find your music and shit, man.
I'm telling you, it's hard for me to find this shit. I'm me.
So whole time, man. What's the next plans and the goals and ambitions and shit like that, man?
Shit, after this, after the tape, we finna promo the shit out the tape, drop videos on that motherfucker. There's 12 songs on it. So it's like, it's all type of vibes on it. So it's like, it's 12 songs. If you telling me you listen to the whole tape and you don't like one song on it, you tripping, bro. Yeah, like, you just hate me. Like, if you just hate me, just say that.
Yeah, in fact.
That's you feel me?
Yeah, right.
It's too many vibes, man. I swear to God, bro. Like, the hard shit, like, every song with the, every feature is that hard shit.
Mm-hmm.
Like, me and Savage, me and Flop, Q, like, the beats is hard, like, just straight thumping. Every other song is like some chill shit. Mm-hmm. So I did this purposely, like, the first song on the tape, Dirty Diana, that's like some chill shit. Second song, Savage, hard shit. Third song, chill. Fourth, hard, like, back to back. So you gonna feel them vibes back to back, like, you gonna feel that facts. Shit. I'm telling you.
I think I asked this question before, but what you honestly think will get you on that next level?
Should you go to that level? Shit, just keep dropping shit.
Shit. Stay consistent on them.
That's all you can do for
okay, consistent. Shit. Is your stuff gonna be on streaming platforms though? Like,
yeah, this shit gonna be Apple Music, iTunes, I mean, Spotify, shit, all the YouTube, all that shit, gonna be everywhere. So shit, anyway, it's on Google. Shit, the first tape on Google. Like I said, I'll type that shit right now. That shit gonna pop up.
Ain't lying though. And part two about to come out.
I'm telling you. And part two gonna be the same way. So the shit about this shit is, bro. That shit fun, like, making this shit fun, like, I don't give a fuck about all the extra shit, like, niggas be bringing too much extra shit in it, like, bro, it don't even be that motherfucking deep, like,
niggas
be making this shit more deeper than what the fuck it is, like, nigga, just chill out and make this music, we can crank out, you feel me, like.
So, whole time, before we wrap this up, you got any last words and stuff, because this battery about to die, so we got, you know what I'm saying?
Wrap it up, shit, all I can say is, till death do us part two on the way, if you fuck with a nigga, I fuck with you. Shit.
Yeah, tell them where they can follow you at and everything like that, man.
Shit. Okay, Jesse James on Instagram and Twitter. O, the letter O K J E S S E J M E S. Bitch ass nigga.
Any words for your haters, man?
Shit, I don't even got haters, bro. I just got niggas that don't like me, bro.
Yeah, fuck.
Who's up with the hater?
Yeah, just a cool nigga like getting, just a cool nigga get money.
Like,
yeah.
I would not like me too if I seen me doing this shit and he wasn't fucking with me, like.
Yeah, facts.
Like, I see ain't nothing to hate or like shit. Yeah. If you fuck with me, I fuck with you.
Mm-hmm.
It's, like, it's simple. Like, if we ain't cool, it's because of you.
Mm-hmm.
My own God.
I see what you're saying.
Other than that, it's fucking nigga.
Yeah, facts. Man, definitely.
Rest in peace, Lil Frank. Go get that bank, nigga.
Yeah, facts. Man, I appreciate it, man. I definitely appreciate the interview, man. You know what I'm saying? We definitely gonna lock in.
Appreciate you coming out here, nigga.
Yeah, bro.
I will call.
Next time if we do part two, please somewhere out there.
This shit
is out here, bro. Like, bro, I just got off of work too, bro.
I'm gonna bring you out Largo, bro.
I can do Largo. We can do Largo. Largo only 10-15 minutes from me, bro. I can get. Yeah, please. We can go do Largo. You can send me do Largo Road. All that. You can send me do all that shit. I'll do it, bro. This shit out here, bro.
Hey, man. For that buddy, your ass gonna slide, my bad. Boy. I'm telling you. When they say buddy talk bullshit, walk. No cap.
Yo, no bullshit, though, man. But nah, we gonna wrap this up right here. It's your boy, Dan V. Hoodz News.
Hey.
And we gone.